Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, together we will turn a website like this. Become like this. Only CSS. In 30 seconds. Yes, you heard right. But before that, let's take a look at what the world's developers are doing with their web design. This is a very popular web design style in the world. Instead of focusing on creating effects for elements, this style creates emphasis by cropping the image into different shapes. Makes your website stand out without making it look too cluttered. This is my current default website interface. This banner image part is the BG image class. The first job. I went to Google and searched for the keyword, grunge brush transparent. It will produce a lot of images. Important remember that we need a PNG image with a transparent background. I think this photo is quite beautiful. So I'm going to download it. But actually this is a photo with a background, which does not meet the requirements. But don't worry. Please visit the BG removal page. And put the bouncing photo here, this website will help us remove the background. So it's done, I saved it and started coding. In CSS, there is a mask image property. When using this attribute, the banner's frame will be cropped according to the image that we will declare in mask image. And the image I chose is the transparent background image. Now test run. Nothing happened. So let's take a look at the list of supported browsers for this CSS property. At a glance, all popular browsers today such as Chrome, Safari, Firefox, Opera are all supported. If you tell me that Internet Explorer is very popular but it doesn't support it. In fact, on Windows computers, Internet Explorer has been abandoned and replaced with another browser, Microsoft Edge. As for Microsoft Edge, it is already supported here. The important thing is why Chrome is supported but when other CSS properties don't work. So please refer to this information. For some specific browsers, such as Chrome, it says it supports this CSS property, but WebKit must be added in front. Some other browsers like Safari are not needed. For this CSS property to work on Chrome, we need to add WebKit in front. It already works, our original image has been cropped to a black image with a transparent background. If you have ever worked with a background image, the way to work with mask image is the same. If you want background image not to repeat, use background repeat. As for mask image, it will be mask repeat. Remember to add WebKit in front. If you want the background image to be in the center of the image, imagine background position, center. As for mask image, it will be mask position, center. If you want to enlarge the background image, use background Z. As for mask image, it will be mask size, with the value being the size you want. There is one very important note. When we write mask image property in WebKit, like this, it helps Chrome browser and some other browsers to work well. However, there are browsers that don't require WebKit to be written, it still works. For example, Safari, Firefox. On the contrary, when there is a WebKit, like this, these browsers will not understand and cannot run anymore. So with mask image, we need to write these properties twice, once with WebKit so that it works on browsers like Chrome, Edge, Opera, Android browser. And for once there is no need for WebKit to run on the remaining browsers. And that's all you need to keep in mind when using this attribute. Now I can replace this image with any image I have that creates this beautiful effect. Every day I will continuously release new videos to share with everyone. If you find this video interesting, don't forget to subscribe to my support channel and to follow new videos. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below the video. I will always support everyone. In addition, if you have any ideas or want to share them with me, please leave a comment. Let's share knowledge and learn together. Thank you. See you all in the next video.